the early days, everybody thought this was stupid. You just received your first autonomous delivery.
Thank you. This is truly mission critical, like life critical.
This technology had to exist in the world.
Whoa, I was not expecting this.
I'm Mohak, and I'm here to learn about how Zipline is built different. I'm here at Zipline to learn how they're building the world's largest autonomous delivery system.
Hey, Mohak.
Hey.
Great to meet you.
Likewise.
Welcome to NetZ. This is actually our biggest test site. We're doing thousands of full autonomous flights day in and day out. So here's an aircraft landing, aircraft taking off, another aircraft heading out to make deliveries.
Everything's completely autonomous.
Everything's completely autonomous. When we started the company, we thought that it should be possible to build a robotic logistics system that would be 10 times as fast, half the cost, zero emission. It just seemed obvious that logistics, because of how repetitive, how boring it is, but also how critical it is, that would be a really important place for robotics to automate.
Like, logistics is hard, but like the entire economy runs on it. And I feel like your thought is like, hey, let's go automate that, because it creates so much more value, you create efficiency, and you actually like end up creating a more sort of a strengthening the economy.
There are gonna be 5.5 billion instant deliveries in the US this year alone. Someone driving a 4,000 pound gas combustion vehicle to a store or to a restaurant or to a hospital to pick something up and then drive it directly to your
someone's house.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, it's phenomenally expensive.
Right.
It's also surprisingly slow. What we're seeing from customer data is that there's actually probably demand for 50 billion instant deliveries in the US. And we can barely hire enough humans to do the 5.5 billion deliveries, let alone the 50 billion. It is very, very clear that to actually provide the scale of service that customers want, we're gonna have to automate it.
Spinning motors, 3, 2, 1. You just launched your first zip.
Yeah, woo, thank you. That was awesome. What about regulatory things you have to navigate?
When we were initially launching, we knew it was gonna be hard to get regulatory approval. The US wasn't quite ready from an FAA perspective. We really wanted to focus on use cases that were so important, so life critical, that even a conservative regulator would be a partner with us. So the first contract we actually signed was to deliver blood transfusions in Rwanda to 21 different hospitals.
Not an easy challenge to pick up as your first thing. I mean, this is truly mission critical, like life critical.
In the early days, everybody told us there was no chance this was gonna work. Mm. So I think that we were pretty determined to show the use case that was so damn important that like—
It would be obvious.
No one would deny it.
That there's no way you could solve this any other way.
50% of transfusions are going toward moms with postpartum hemorrhaging. 30% are going toward kids under the age of 5. We could find countries that were small, startup-y, willing to create new regulatory paradigms quickly to try something in a way that you just couldn't do in a bigger country like the US. And then once we had 50, 60, 70 million commercial autonomous miles, we were able to bring that back to the US.
Wait, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, what just?
Yeah, what just happened? Vehicles flying by at 70 miles an hour and you're aiming for a 1 centimeter target on the aircraft.
That is incredible.
Yeah, you wanna come check it out?
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, so most of the weight's in the battery probably.
Yeah, most of the weight is in the battery. Okay, let's go to platform 2. Platform 2 really came from a lot of big companies looking at what we were doing internationally and saying, hey, we want to do it here and we want to automate delivery directly to homes.
It wasn't from hub to hub, it was literally get the last mile.
Yeah.
It's a distributor network. It's not even like,
exactly.
Like literally.
There's no distribution center.
I have a restaurant, I take one of these, it becomes my delivery system.
Right. We expect to expand dramatically through this summer, delivering to millions of people. You should be able to pull out your phone, press a button on it, get whatever you want delivered in a way that is 10 times as fast, zero emission, just a way better customer experience.
What are the metrics you care about? Like, how do you think about what success looks like?
We're pushing to have as many deliveries sub 15 minutes as humanly possible, all deliveries sub 30 minutes. We can actually hear a zip coming over to make a delivery to us.
All right.
The vehicle delivers from 100 meters up.
Oh, it never descends.
No, it never descends. As soon as it gets into position, it's gonna start lowering the delivery zip.
It's actually directly above us, but it's delivering over there.
Yeah.
Because it knows the way the wind is blowing.
So it can deliver super, super accurately.
You said that that thing delivers within a one...
Yeah, it's like dinner plate. Think of it as like dinner plate level accuracy is what we're going for.
Just pops it right out and that's it.
Just delivered your product.
Dude, that's cool.
And it's gone.
This is amazing.
You just received your first autonomous delivery.
Thank you. So welcome to the future.
Yeah, exactly.
all the Zips get built here?
Every single one that you just saw flying is 100% here. So this is our delivery Zip line right here.
So this one small thing that pops up.
Exactly.
Yeah. So light.
Isn't that incredible?
So light.
Our harnesses are pretty unique. We're actually using flexible printed circuits as our harnessing scheme. We were actually able to pull out hundreds of grams off of our vehicle.
Just from harnesses?
Just by harnesses alone.
Every gram on here is a gram fewer for the actual payload, the delivery payload.
That's 100%. Totally correct.
How much does this totally weigh?
About 2 kilograms.
Wow.
So, yeah.
It delivers up to 4 kilograms of payload.
Yeah, yep, that's right. Yep. You know, we weigh 1% of what a car weighs.
For the same delivery.
For the same delivery. If you're getting a private taxi for your burrito, it's overkill. So for us, both having something that requires way less emissions to operate, but also has a really long life is key.
I love the point about the harnesses. Like, that's fantastic from a weight perspective. Is there a trade-off that comes with that in terms of survivability or things you have to do with shielding? Like, how have you been able to negotiate those trade-offs?
Yeah, we want to make it as reliable as possible, but if something goes wrong, we've still got to be safe. And so we test the most extreme vibration, the most extreme temperatures, the most extreme environmental conditions that we will ever see, so we can find that weakness in the design way before we would ever see it in test or in the field, sure, and fix it before we even know about it.
Whoa! Woo! I was not expecting this.
Tell me about how you handle like failure situations.
Off nominals.
Yeah.
Like any airplane, you have to design redundancy into the system. We have to guarantee these systems are going to operate safely in the real world. That means you have to build redundancy into every part of the aircraft. We can lose any motor, any part of the powertrain on the aircraft, we can still fly home safely. You can actually reach into the airplane while it's flying and cut any wire. The vehicle will still be able to fly itself. Our goal has been to design a system that is 10 times as safe as a similar car doing that delivery.
Doing that delivery, yeah. And to your point, it's played out in your safety record.
Our safety track record right now is pretty extraordinary. I mean, we have flown 100 million commercial autonomous miles with zero human safety incidents.
And so incredible.
This system is already dramatically safer than using cars to do similar deliveries.
Yeah. How do you think about, you know, your vision and bridging these two what feel like really different goals? Like, on one hand, it's serving, you know, the ability for people to deliver meals. On the other hand, is like delivering life-saving medicine. Like, how do you think about all of that living inside of one business, one platform?
5.5 million kids lose their lives every year due to lack of access to basic medical products. Actually solving these humanity level problems is going to require capitalism and it's going to require technology. So we really think that the future is mission-driven for-profit companies deploying next-generation technology, next-generation infrastructure in the parts of the world that need it the most.
There was something I heard earlier from talking to one of the doctors in Rwanda who's been the beneficiary of the service you provided there. And it's really interesting. What they basically said was the logistics challenges being removed actually changed not just the quality of care, but the nature of care.
Being able to achieve a 51% reduction in maternal mortality, I think most people would not have thought that was possible for a logistics system.
Yeah.
I think that logistics is like, it's the hidden connector, you know, where it's like, if you have a great logistics system, you totally transform where you deliver care, how you deliver care, how high quality it is.
There's a thing we say at LinkedIn, which is, you know, there's a lot of companies that do good, but they don't tend to necessarily do well, and they don't do it at massive scale. It's really hard doing good at massive scale. We like to think that like LinkedIn is doing that. Sounds like that's essentially what you're doing here at Zipline.
That's always been the mission.
Yeah.
I grew up actually in like a farm town in Missouri. Mm-hmm. So I have a pretty sick mom at home. And oftentimes the local pharmacy would miss a shipment. And I have thought about how my childhood may have been a little bit differently if we could just have gotten the medicine when she actually needed it.
Logistics feels like such a mundane thing, but the reality is that mundane things actually solve profound problems in the way that we interact with each other, in the way that we create economic opportunity, in the way that we as culture and society moves forward. By tackling urgent healthcare challenges in Rwanda, Zipline proved that autonomous delivery can have real human impact. As the company grows in the US, it's unlocking how people get food, medicine, and essential supplies, offering a sustainable and scalable blueprint for a delivery platform that's truly built different.